straight up, man. The Lord is, he's called this real man, man. He's putting that, we're standing on our feet and great boldness against this devil, man. All right, we ain't finna hold hand, we ain't finna extend our hand to this devil, man. We're gonna condemn and prophesy against him.
The joy of the whole earth, all thy enemies.
Israelites, God's children. expectation comes with them having the position to allow you niggas to utilize your negative energy, your stereotypes, you know, all the different things that a society runs with concerning you. They help you perpetuate that. You put it in the form of entertainment, and then that's the way all the nations see you. And they exploit that and make money off of that, man.
Hey, how many t-shirts y'all straight out of Compton, t-shirts straight out of wherever?
Yeah.
The whole album cover, they got that on every t-shirt right now. With any straight out of vocab, straight out of Israel.
Yeah, mocking.
Mocking. But that's what they do on the level of our people, on the levels of our people. They mock our people. But they also secretly want to follow it too.
Yeah, because they get
some of the VP.
Yeah, it's
ignorance. It was the same in the world. Everybody want to be a nigga, but don't nobody want to be a nigga. Everybody want to be Jake, but don't nobody want to be Jake. Because you got the curses that come with it. But if you were Jake, then you have the elected, you got the Heavenly Father, and everything that comes with the kingdom and the beauty of it. You know?
Yeah, so these nations, you know, this is part of them not suffering our bodies to be put in graves, man.
Right.
Them forwarding, help forwarding the afflictions, man. Ishmael coming over here setting up these goddamn, you know, little food joints, selling y'all another buffet food.
These abominations.
Yeah, selling us all type of camel meat and shit. You know,
dog.
They got stores and convenience stores selling you all type of pork and yeah, man, horror meat. They call it horror. You know, they selling you all this alcohol and cigarettes and loosies and all the shit that destroys your body, man. Popping off women. Moab, they doing the same shit, man. You know, it was one point in time, which I'm pretty sure they still capitalize off of it. The hip-hop culture comes within the culture of our music, comes the style of our trends and our fashion.
Yeah.
When they see how violent Jake is in the hip hop world, which they come with that street mentality, they look at how Jake dressed in the hood. So if you keep
white
perpetuating t-shirt. That look, these nations know, like, okay, they dress white tees, okay, check. Or they wear the fitted hats. In LA, each fitted hat is a hood.
Dickies.
So they make sure they shipping all this attire that all the gangsters, all the niggas, how they dress, they perpetuate that mentality, that style of dress to keep these niggas at war, man.
Yeah, yeah.
That's also part of the forwarding of the affliction, man.
Sensitive against the hidden one.
Yeah. You know? So they play into every aspect of those pitfalls and those traps that this devil has for you Jakes, man.
Dropping guns.
Dropping crates of guns in the hood.
Styles.
Yeah.
Boys in the hood. Larry Fishburne said it. He said, why is there a liquor store on every corner? A gun shop on every corner? A church on every corner? Wants to kill ourselves. You know, you see that shit, right?
That was part of the conspiracy. Those are the physical things that take up Marvin Jake's body, but like you also said, the churches. You know, because in those churches it comes from
Zechariah 1:15.
It's Zechariah 1:15. Now I have very sore displeased with the heathen that are at ease. For I was but a little displeased, and they are filled with the affliction.
That's those dogs licking on the souls, man. Making our conditions even worse, helping conspire with each other to keep us down and oppressed and afflicted, man. Okay? Us being a byword, a proverb among the nations, when we down and out, man. These nations, they kick us while we're down. Esau, he try to stomp us to death, you know. Straight up, man. Go ahead. And this parable is deep, man. A lot of people don't understand the deep understanding of Yahweh Shai breaking this down, man. This was a prophetic parable. A lot of the parables that the Lord spoke was prophetic, man. To the rich man. He had to sell out to the rich man. Which that rich man is the damn devil, man.
Right. He says, and it came to pass that the beggar died. He was carried by the angels unto Abraham's bosom. The rich man also died and was buried. He says, and in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torments.
It's not talking about when you die, you go into the center of the earth,
Hades.
Into a fiery pit, and the demon and the tail and the red. Yeah, it's not stabbing you with a pitchfork and shit. That's not talking about that. It's talking about a translation to kingdoms, man, a transference to kingdoms, man. All right? Lazarus is going to be on top, which are the Israelites. And the so-called white man is going to be on the bottom. All the curses that the Israelites face, all right, for the last 500 years, all right, under these other nations, under the so-called white man, all right, these other nations are going to be the lowest on the totem pole.
It's the movie that played it out well was Trading Places with Dan Aykroyd and Eddie Murphy.
The one with Sidney Poitier and John Travolta.
Oh, White Man's Burden?
Yeah. White Man's Burden, yeah.
Second as a six and nine.
Esau gonna be double what we got. Esau gonna be living in pits, man. We gonna put the whole nation, their habitation is gonna be in pits. And that's in the book of Isaiah, I believe. Alright? They gonna come out them pits and they gonna work, man. They gonna be slaves on earth, man, building up the kingdom. Alright? The Israelites ain't gonna build up the kingdom.
And just like
the other nations are.
Just like the Egyptians didn't eyes, being in torments, and seeing Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom.
Lazarus in his bosom. All right. Meaning he's gonna be in the secret place of the Most High, man. He's gonna be in the Lord's the comforting that the Lord has for his sons, man. Right now we're being comforted with this word. We're being gathered into the bosom with this word right now. And then the Lord's gonna physically gather us, and he gonna bring us in his wings, so to speak, man. Okay. These devils, they're gonna be afar off. Okay, and they're witnessing Israel return, and he's getting ready to fall. Okay? So now we're in the middle of that transitioning of the rise of Jacob and the fall of Esau. Alright? That's what's happening. And now everything is starting to reverse. Now, Jacob. We're getting this truth, we're becoming more and more of the Lord's sons, while Esau is becoming more and more based, even within his own kingdom. That's why you're starting to see more depression with the so-called white man. All right, the poverty rate is increasing among the white population. All right, you literally got sleeping Edomite bones all around you, man. You got the opioid epidemic. You got more Edomites dying than being born. Okay? It's a lot happening. The Lord is making these devils small among the heathen and greatly despised. So basically the curses are beginning to come upon him. All right? But hey, you was that rich man. You was sitting in high position. You had everything that the heart could wish for. Tells you that in was that Psalms the 73rd chapter, man. You know, for I was envious at the prosperity of the wicked, man. You know, he speak lawfully concerning our oppression. Okay, all these things, man. That you oppressed, the people that you look down upon, now they're in a lofty position, and now you're on the bottom. And get Psalms 78 and 5. And also 1 Samuel 2 and 8.
Psalm 78.
I think it's 5.
That word Lazarus means whom God helps. Whom the Most High helps. So the Lord is about to help us, man. Alright? He's about to save us out of this captivity.
Set them among princes, and to make them inherit.
That was first thing.
darkness.
So that's the rich man. Right? He's gonna be a dope. He's gonna be in hell. It tells you that in Isaiah the 14th chapter, man.
Yep.
You know, hell is prepared for you, but beneath it's stirred up the chief ones of the nations, man. Because you are gonna be in captivity under the Israelites.
That's what hell is, man. It's a condition on earth.
Yep.
Yeah, we're going to be in our heaven, man. That's why it's called the kingdom of heaven, the kingdom of Israel.
Sirach, Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, chapter 16, verse 4, it says, "For by one that have understanding shall the city be replenished, but the kindred of the wicked shall speedily become desolate." That's talking about the righteous is going to raise up. Even though we're the beggar right now,
y'all can see it, man. Your economy is being broken down.
You're divided.
You're divided politically.
Yeah.
Okay, there's no peace between y'all. You know? Like it says, the kingdom divided against itself shall not stand. So you're being broken up. You're deteriorating, man. Those worms are spreading underneath you, man. You're corroding.
Same thing the Most High, I mean, the Esau did that, divide and conquer. Same thing the Most High is doing today.
Thy pomp is brought down to the grave, and the noise of thy violence, the worm is spread unto thee, and the worm is covered thee. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer?
Alright, Lucifer means light there. Because he don't believe in the Most High. Alright? But the elites know there's a there's a supreme being, man. But your lower level Edomites, all right, you don't believe, man. All right, that's why you're coming out with this artificial intelligence. All right, that's why you're coming out with the RFID chip. All right, the mark of the beast. You're trying to rule over everybody, man. All right.
You're trying to reduce the world's population. You're trying to have control over how many souls or spirits are allowed to be on the earth.
Yeah.
He thinks he's the Most High, like, you know, that's a God complex.
Yeah. You're trying to clock and survey, survey people with this RFID chip that's coming out. You know.
Yeah, he wants to know your thoughts.
Yeah.
Your thought patterns and stuff like that. And he's creating technology to be able to have that ability. You know?
Yeah, he's gonna try to put regulations on sex, on breeding. They're already doing that out there in China.
Kind.
All right.
Crazy, man.
He's also trying to make it where you gotta have a. Didn't we say we had to have a consent to have sex with a woman now?
They got certain apps now.
Yeah, apps. There you go. Yeah.
Pretty much the agreement. Gotta be. Electronic, so that she can't yell rape and shit, you know, which is a goddamn shame, man. But only under the rule of these devils that you got that going on.
You know, one thing we're waiting to corrupt that system.
Is gonna be the curses coming upon him. Alright? basically that cup, that the cup of the Lord's indignation, man, and the cup that we drunk, yep. We was up under him, he got to drink it now.
Double.
You got to drink double, a double dose.
And the praise.
All right. I got it.